Wait, hold on. There is a new Mac Mini Pro? Or what's this?
In this video, I will show you how to transform your Mac Mini into a Mac Mini Pro. Hi, I'm Teresa from morgonow.com and I specialize on one-on-one coaching and remote help to individuals as well as audio and video production houses all around the globe. So if you would need any help with your Apple Mac, Windows, Linux, servers, DaVinci Resolve and more, then you can in few clicks schedule a Zoom video call with me and remote session to your computer so I can help you right in front of your eyes. Link is in this video description. So, you have an Apple Mac Mini. Right, perfect, that's great, congratulations. I love mine too, but now you are probably thinking about getting some USB or Thunderbolt dock, so you can connect more stuff, have an SD card reader and so on. But what if your computer would have the dock built in, so there would be no need for extra cables and power bricks? I am glad I discovered this company called Orico, manufacturing really high-end stuff, just like this, Orico Mini Pro. Can't wait to show you how it works. Orico Mini Pro is exclusively designed for the Mac Mini M4, M4 Pro. In the package, you will find a box with accessories, specifically with the short braided 10 gigabits per second USB-C to USB-C cable, two quite thick thermal pads for NVMe, and single screw and a screwdriver. It's made from aviation-grade aluminium alloy. It feels really premium, just like the 2019 and 2023 Mac Pro. To install your Mac Mini inside, just slide the button on the top of the case and detach the whole side panel. Now grab your Mini and just slide it into the rubber holders in the corners. The Orico Mini Pro fixes the main Mac Mini annoyance, and that's the power button placement. Now you have easy access to it right from the side, and it has now nice tactile clicky feedback. You have full access to all Mac Mini ports, 3.5mm jack on the front, status LED diode, as well as two USB-C ports. But on the bottom, you gain dual SD/TF card readers with simultaneous 100 MB per second read speeds. That's perfect for photo and videographers. On the back, you have easy access to all Mac Mini ports. And on the bottom, there are additional two USB-A 10 gigabits per second ports. That's very welcome addition. Orico Mini Pro doesn't need any extra power brick. It's fully powered by the included USB-C cable right off of the Mac Mini itself. So no more extra cables needed. Underneath the single screw on the bottom, you will find the NVMe bay. You can get the Orico Mini Pro without any SSD and save some money and install your preferred NVMe, or to get it as I did with the 2TB Orico J10 NVMe SSD. It comes packed with two additional heatsinks and thermal pads for use in any desktop computer or laptop. Just slide the NVMe into the slot, place on top of it one of the included thermal pads. By the way, don't forget to peel off the protective film layer. Now close the door and secure it by the single screw. Done! That's so easy! Anybody can do it in just a minute. When you will connect the Orico Mini Pro with the built-in internal SSD for the first time, you would need to format the SSD first for the correct file system for macOS, which is APFS and GUID. Let me show you how to do that. So you can click here on the Initialize button or open Disk Utility manually. Make sure in the View section you have Show All Devices. And here in the left column you can see the name of the disk. I don't know why it's called Realtek, but it is the Orico provided disk. And it's correctly showing the 2TB in size. So on the top right corner, click on Erase button and call it, let's say, okay, Orico 2TB. Format APFS and partition scheme GUID and click on Erase. Perfect. So, what speeds we can expect? Darling, it's connected using only a single 10 gigabit USB cable, so I don't expect any mind-blowing speeds, but plenty enough for 4K video editing. So, let me check it for you. So, let's choose the new disk here. Orico, open and start. Yes, as expected, we are running somewhere around 800 megabytes per second on the read side. And because of the limitations of the 10 gigabit USB, I expect the same also for the read speed. Okay, so 800 megabytes per second write speed and 860 megabytes per second read speed. So the internal disk inside is the PCI Express by 4, but generation 3. So it should be roughly around 3000 megabytes per second capable disk. But because it's connected using the USB-C, which is 10 gigabit cable, that's why we have these speeds. But darling, don't get be fooled, because these speeds are perfectly fine for even multicam 8K video production. So all is okay. Honestly, I really fell in love with this Orico Mini Pro. So don't be surprised, you will see it on my desk also in future videos. So now this is great opportunity to get just the base model Mac Mini M4, which is the best value overall, despite it has just the funny 250 gigabyte small disk. Because with the Orico Mini Pro, you can now move your whole iCloud Drive, Dropbox, Google Drive and so on onto this built-in 2TB NVMe and take full advantage of your iCloud locally. I showed step-by-step tutorial how to do it in detail in this video here. If you've got something out of this video, give it a like and feel free to subscribe and enable all notifications so you won't miss any of my future useful videos. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye-bye, take care.